Oh, please. I love the countdown. I can't wait. Welcome back, friends. As you can tell today, we're going to be talking about some of the more unbelievable things that can happen when a whale dies. For anyone who's new, I'm KP, a marine biologist who specializes in marine mammals. So why in the world would a whale explode? Most famously, in 2004, when a 60-ton sperm whale was transported through the streets of Taiwan and spontaneously exploded, showering cars and shops with blood and organs and stopping traffic for hours. There was also the ill-fated decision in 1970 by the Oregon Department of Transportation to explode a washed-up sperm whale in order to help expedite the decomposition process.
Well, I'm confident that it'll
look
work.
At this little
the
kid
only
here.
Thing is, we're not sure just exactly how much explosives it'll take to disintegrate this thing. So the
I like a lot of uncertainty in my explosives. They were even in luck. There was a military vet who was in the area with explosives training. He recommended that they use about 20 sticks of dynamite or 3.8 kilos. Knowing that that would be more than enough. But as we know from some of our past videos, like the disappearance of the snow crabs, people don't always like to listen to the experts. So instead of the recommended 20 sticks of dynamite, they went with 20 cases. That's 450 kilos of explosives, when, if you recall, 3.8 kilos was what was recommended.
We're moved back a quarter of a mile away.
Quarter of a mile.
The sand dunes there were covered with spectators and landlubber newsmen.
It seems far away. Newsmen. It does. Oh, please. I love the countdown. I can't wait. Wait, listen. They're all excited. It starts to rain. Not actual rain. Here comes the pieces, she says.
The explosion ended up throwing whale schmegma over 800 feet into the sky. And what goes up must come down. Reporters on the scene described people running for their lives as decomposing whale goop fell from the sky. Now, I have actually personally smelled the decomposing whale schmegma from a blue whale. It's horrifying. And yes, in case you were wondering, schmegma is the actual scientific name for rotting whale blubber.
Our camera stopped rolling immediately after the blast.
Because we were splattered by schmegma.
The situation suddenly gave way to a run for survival as huge chunks of whale blubber fell
run
everywhere.
For survival!
Pieces of meat falling debris in the overhead.
Oh my gosh, look at the cars,
a parked car over
man.
A quarter of a mile from the blast site was the target of one large chunk. Fortunately, no human was hit as badly as the car.
Insurance cover that, do we think? All right, this was obviously a man-made explosion, but whale carcasses can explode naturally on their own. But why would this happen?
I think the first thing to understand here is that whales are not just big, they are massive. They are, in fact, the largest animals to ever live on planet Earth. Bigger than the dinosaurs. And when animals die, they provide lots of life-giving nutrients to animals further down the food chain. In shallow waters, these whale carcasses will be consumed very quickly by animals like polar bears, seagulls, and other scavengers. Even some smaller organisms like bacteria. However, in some warmer climates when the conditions are right, those bacteria begin to multiply and they produce methane gas. Whale skin is thick and covered in blubber on the underside. That makes it very stretchy. If the skin is intact when the animal dies, then it will just begin to expand almost like a balloon until it explodes. But exploding whales are actually pretty rare, and that is because big whales like sperm whales and blue whales actually are denser than seawater. They are only buoyant when their lungs are filled with air, so usually once they die, they quickly sink to the ocean floor. as we see in this video by Oceanlab at the University of Aberdeen.
Oh, cool. Look at the little octopus. Wow. So obviously a baleen whale. Look at the pose of the octopus in the back. He was like, whoa, look at all these snacks, he seemed to say.
The bathyal and abyssal zones of the ocean floor are cold and dark places. The temperature hovers just above freezing and the hydrostatic pressure is intense. We're talking 5,800 pounds per square inch, or the weight of an SUV. And these extreme conditions can preserve a whale carcass for decades. The importance of these whale falls is a relatively recent discovery. When industrial deep sea trawling began in the 20th century, commercial fishermen began finding new species of mollusks attached to the whale bones that they were unintentionally bringing up in their nets. This led researchers to formulate a hypothesis that these deep sea whale falls are evolutionary stepping stones for some creatures. They decided to conduct several experiments with whale carcasses that had washed up on the California coast. Rather than blow them up with dynamite, though, they towed them out to sea and allowed them to sink. It's a good time to remember just how big these animals are. An adult blue whale weighs more than 40 elephants, 30 T-Rex, or 2,670 average-sized Americans. The amount of carbon in a single whale carcass is estimated to be the equivalent of over 1,000 trees. The sheer amount of organic material reaching the ocean floor when a whale falls creates something known as a biological pulse. And that is what researchers discovered when they began revisiting these whale fall sites. They found that a single dead whale will nourish a specialized ecosystem for decades. Many of these ecosystems are just a few kilometers apart, allowing these deep sea communities to overlap and biodiversify, creating new species. That's right, among the many animals found at these whale fall sites were entirely new species. At least 30 new species of deep sea creature have been discovered at these whale fall sites. But that's far from the end of the story, because it's estimated that the commercial whaling industry reduced the total biomass of the deep sea by more than 30% and dramatically altered the ocean's ability to store and sequester carbon. And that's just one of the many reasons that it's so important that we protect these amazing animals. Because while the death of a great whale acts as a powerful biological pump, we of course want them to die of natural causes. Many of these great whales are critically endangered. And the leading cause of death for these animals right now are ship strikes, entanglements, and ingestion of foreign objects such as microplastics. The good news is, of course, there are a lot of things that we can do to protect these whales. Basically, it boils down to learning from our mistakes. Just like we now know that 20 sticks of dynamite will blow up a whale, and 20 cases is overkill. We can listen to the experts who strongly urge us to eat only sustainably caught seafood and to lessen the use of plastics in our everyday lives, which we talk a bit more about in the video on microplastics you can find right up here. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll catch you next time. Cheers. But the sheer amount of organic material reaching the ocean Just like the new species of mussel that I mentioned earlier, that the fishing people, the people who do the fishing.
Looks like it's probably a sperm whale.
Since a whale had washed up in Lane County, nobody could remember how to get rid of one. It couldn't be cut up and then buried because nobody wanted to cut it up.
They do now, you know, they do necropsies on animals like this, so There are people who will definitely cut them up, and I've never had the pleasure of going on a big whale necropsy, but I'd do it. I think it'd be pretty cool.